Chip, you know, obviously the White House anticipated this blowout in the House of Representatives. Are they at least breathing a sigh of relief about how things are unfolding in the Senate so far?
I tell you, Katie, if they're breathing, nobody really knows, because the silence here is deafening. And I just walked into the press area in the West Wing, where we in the media can actually walk in and talk to people. It was completely deserted. Everybody has scattered to either to other parts of the West Wing, or they've simply gone home. They have gone under at this point, and it's not clear what they're going to say to us tonight. If anything, they may just wait for the president to give his response tomorrow when he holds his press conference at 1 in the afternoon Eastern time.
I read that he's going to talk about the importance of bipartisanship. Do you think, how will the White House change its tone and approach towards their Republican brethren in Congress?
Well, that's the $64,000 question right now, Katie. I'm sure it's being heatedly debated at the White House tonight, and it will be tomorrow. Do they really sincerely offer an olive branch to the Republicans? Do they say, okay, you won, we cry uncle, we're going to work with you? Or do they keep a bit of that combative tone and say, hey, as the president has done all through this campaign, saying, I'm the one who wanted to work together, you're the ones who did not? I would not be surprised if you still hear a little bit of that tone. I don't think they're going to simply give in and say, you won, we're ready to compromise with you. I think it's going to be a standoff for quite a while here. I mean, these are political warriors. They've been doing this for a long time now. I don't suddenly expect them to change dramatically overnight. On the other hand, I do expect a lot of words about compromise from the president tomorrow.
All right, Chip Reed at the White House. Thank you so much, Chip.